Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss about trigonometry. As the word goes, it has been derived from Greek word where tri means three, gono means sides, and metri means measure. In earlier classes, you must have learned about triangles, different type of triangles, right angle triangle, acute triangle, etc. Friends, maths is not about only mugging up of formulas, identities, proving, etc. So let us not try to mug up the things and try to understand from our surroundings, from our environment, from our practical life and different type of experiment. I will give you an example where a right angle triangle can be imagined and can be formed. You say, suppose we take an example of visiting an Eiffel Tower. Suppose you are visiting an Eiffel Tower and you have gone to visit it, and this is an Eiffel Tower and you are standing here at some distance and you are looking at the top of the tower from your place. So, does it look like a triangle? Is it so? Now friends, can you find the height of an Eiffel Tower from where you are standing without measuring it in an actual manner? Now, the second example I am giving it to you. Suppose you are sitting in a sea facing or a sea view hotel room at a sixth floor on the top. Here, at the sixth floor of a hotel room. Okay? And you are viewing a temple on the other side of a road. This is so less. Other side of the road. Here. So, from sitting here, can you, at some height, can you say me the what is the distance of this temple from this hotel where you are sitting? And the answer is yes. We can find the solution of these questions where a right angle triangle has been made. One from this angle and the other from this angle. And the angle which is going up is called angle of elevation. And the angle which is coming down is called angle of depression. From here we were watching and you were sitting here, and from here you were watching the temple. So angle of depression, you were looking down, angle of depression. Looking up, from here you were watching the Eiffel Tower, the height of Eiffel Tower, and this is called angle of elevation. There are many type of such example in our practical life, in our day-to-day life, which we saw, which we see, and which we feel. And these are the application of the trigonometry. So from this, what we can conclude is trigonometry is the study of side of a triangle, study of a relationship between a side of a triangle and angle of a triangle. Now we will study about some ratios of a triangle with respect to acute angle, and these are called trigonometric ratios. So now we draw a right angle triangle. Here it is a right angle at angle B, and this is an acute angle. We denote it by theta. Acute angle means 0 degree to 90 degree, angle between 0 degree to 90 degree, and this is your perpendicular, this is your hypotenuse, and this is your base adjacent to angle theta. Clear everyone? Now there are different type of ratios, trigonometric ratios, such as sine ratio, sine of angle C. I have drawn angle at angle C, so we are using sine of angle C, and it is perpendicular by hypotenuse. That is, perpendicular means A to B and hypotenuse A to C. So perpendicular is A to B and hypotenuse is A to C. First ratio was sine of angle C, second is cosine of angle C, that is base by hypotenuse, and that is BC by AC. Now third is tangent. Third ratio is known as tangent of angle C. As I have drawn theta at angle C, so we are writing it here C. This is perpendicular by base. That is AB by BC. These three are the basic identities, trigonometric ratios. And now, as this is a small board, now we come to the other three, that is cosec of angle C, secant of angle C, and cotangent. That was tangent and this is cotangent of angle C. Now cosec is hypotenuse by perpendicular, that is AC by AB, and cosec is hypotenuse by base, that is AC by BC, and cotangent is base